again.
Yes, Italy's cost of borrowing remained at record levels today, despite the new leadership of the economist Mario Monti, also known as Super Mario. And the uncertainty has also spread to Spain, with Spanish debt trading at its highest levels since August. It comes as new figures showed industrial production in the Eurozone fell by 2% at the end of the summer. Mariana Mazzucato is an economist at the University of Sussex, and she joins us now. Good evening.
Good evening.
Now, the resignation of Silvio Berlusconi doesn't appear to have made much difference to the confidence of investors. Why not?
Well, I think it's probably because in this case, the market is actually quite intelligent. And if you look at the growth figures for Italy, it's actually been about 15 years of very low growth, basically between 0 and 0.75%. And the austerity budget, which Mario Monti probably will be able to pass through both the first and the second, isn't actually going to help much. If you actually look at the details of the budget, it's mainly around things like increases in healthcare fees, cuts to regional subsidies, reduction of family tax benefits, cutting public sector workers, freezing new recruitment, stuff like that. None of these measures are really going to create growth. And what's really important to understand with Italy is that it's not true that it's been spending too much. In fact, it's been spending too little. Its deficit is quite low, but its debt to GDP ratio is very high. It's 120%. But that's simply because the interest rate that it pays on its debt is much higher than its growth rate. And as long as that stays true, Italy will have an increasing debt to GDP ratio, and it's not going to be able to pay it back. And that's what markets care about.
I suppose the problem is that investors are dictating what Italy has to do. It doesn't really have much choice. So where does this leave us then? Does it mean that this crisis is not going to be solved by austerity measures and it's going to end in something pretty disastrous?
Well, I think you've just hit the nail on the head, which is that financial markets actually, unfortunately, don't care about the long run. It's all about sort of the short run. In this case, I think they are jittery because they're worried about the growth rate. But the fact, the growth rate on the one hand, it's a long run issue because you actually have to invest in order to achieve growth. But they also know that because the current growth rate is so low, the debt to GDP ratio is going to keep rising. And I think we have to go beyond Italy. This is actually also a question for this country with the current austerity budget in the UK, which is, do you actually want to run a country based on the short-run concerns of financial markets, or do we actually have to step back and, start rethinking what it means to create policies which actually reward, for example, those companies that do invest in the long run in human capital formation, in training, in innovation, which is extremely expensive. Currently, financial markets actually reward those companies. So on the one hand, we're all concerned about these financial markets and what, is happening to the credit ratings of these different countries. But if we actually follow their recipes, yes, we're going to make the situation much worse. So we actually need quite courageous leaders. For example, what Brazil has done and Argentina did in Latin America, which is they actually turned their backs to the IMF during the years that they were being forced to impose austerity measures. And they said, you know what, to grow, we're not going to be able to, grow if we actually do swallow that very austere recipe. And they have, in fact, been the countries in Latin America which have been growing. Same thing with China.
Unfortunately, it doesn't look like our leaders are that courageous at the moment, does it?
No, absolutely. But also, in terms of the Eurozone, it's also not very courageous in terms of how the ECB is acting. In order to have a euro that works, you need courageous and cohesive monetary and fiscal policy. In terms of monetary policy, you need, as many people have started to learn lots of economic terms, you need a lender of last resort. So a central bank that actually will help different nations when they start to potentially go, default, which doesn't mean to constantly bail them out, but to give them that room. And so currently what should be happening is for the ECB to be buying very actively Italian bonds, but which they've started to do, but it's sort of too little and too late because of the contagion.
Thank you very much for talking to us. Very interesting. Mariana Mazzucato from the University of Sussex.